boy, another day in Wormwood Forest.
Hello, boys and girls. It's time for another visit with our animal friends down in Wormwood Forest.
Hey, don't run away. Listen a while, you'll want to stay. There's always lots of fun down in Wormwood Forest.
Hello, everybody. This is Dippy Dwarf. Today, Susie Skunk has trouble with her radio. Just at soap opera time.
So don't leave your radio. Listen to our animal show. There's always lots of fun down in Wormwood Forest.
Good gracious, someone's at the door. Just a minute. Oh, goodness. If you're working your way through barber school by selling haircuts, I don't... Oh, hello, Kitty.
Hello, Susie Skunk.
Do come in, Kitty. I must rush right back to the kitchen.
Very well. Why the rush to the kitchen, Susie?
I don't want my cabbage to burn.
Not skunk cabbage. I had a feeling I should have stayed home.
Don't be that way, Kitty. If you're hungry, you don't have to eat skunk cabbage. I'll give you a dish of whipped cream.
I am a bit hungry. Where's the whipped cream?
I'll have to whip it first. The cream is in the sugar bowl, and I need the egg beater.
I don't like eggs.
The egg beater is to whip the cream. Now, let me see. I must have put it in my purse. If I can remember where I put my purse.
Under the scatter rug?
Not this time. Oh, I remember. My purse is in my sewing basket.
In your sewing basket?
Uh-huh. Someone said it looked threadbare.
Oh.
Oh, here it is. Now, the egg beater. Eggs. Oh, look, Kitty, a pair of skis.
A pair of skis in your purse?
They're very short skis. A jar of prickly pear pickles, a back scratcher, a portable mugwump.
What's a mugwump?
That's a good question, Kitty. Oh, a piece of fudge cake. Now, what was I looking for?
An egg beater.
Oh, yes, an egg beater. Pink and shears. Oh, and here's the egg beater. I knew it would be in my purse somewhere.
Good. Now I can beat the eggs.
Eggs? I thought you were going to whip the cream, Kitty.
Oh, the cream, of course. Hand me that bowl.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll pour in the cream, and I'll whip it till it's as fluffy as my fur, which is gorgeous but beautiful.
I wonder what time it is. 2:30. Oh, gracious, it's time for my favorite radio program.
Which one's your favorite now, Sue?
Oh, about three of them. I hate to show partiality, but now it's time for Sadie Snake, Girl Reptile. I'll turn on my radio. Kitty, it went kerfoof.
You mean the radio won't work?
No, it played out. I guess I'll have to have it repaired.
But what about all this whipped cream?
Well, you stay here and enjoy the whipped cream, Kitty, and I'll take my radio out to be repaired.
Very well. It's too cold for me to stroll around Wormwood anyway.
Now, where are my bonnet and fascinator? Oh, here they are. I won't be any longer than necessary, Kitty.
Oh, take your time, Sue.
Ooh, it's cold out here. I'd better tie this fascinator around my neck. But I can't do that and hold the radio, too. I'll just put my radio down on this rock. Oh, there. Now I can tie... Oh, the rock's moving. Rock, come back here with my radio. Rock! Oh, it's not a rock. It's Timothy Turtle. Hello, Tim.
Oh, hi, Susie Skunk.
What's the matter, Turtle?
I don't think I feel very good.
Does your tummy hurt, Timmy?
Not my tummy, my back. My shell feels like it weighs a ton.
Oh, well, maybe that's because I put my radio on your back.
Your radio?
Uh-huh. Here, I'll take it off.
Say, I feel like a new turtle already. Would you care to dance?
Tim!
Only joking. Don't know how to dance a step.
Then you should go over to Grandpa Fox's poultry farm.
Oh, nothing but hens over there.
Well, they could teach you to dance the chicken reel.
I'd much rather learn to do the bunny hug.
I don't know any bunny dancing teachers. By the time the bunnies learn to teach dancing, they've grown into rabbits.
Well, guess I'll have to forget dancing lessons. What you doing with your radio?
Well, I've got to have it repaired, Tim. Could you recommend a good radio repairman?
Frankie Frog's good at fixing things.
He is?
Sure. When I busted the zipper on my turtle shell, he fixed it but good.
Then I must find Frankie Frog.
He's probably over at the Dwarf Waldorf, Susie.
Oh, thanks so much for your suggestion, Turtle.
Oh, don't mention it. Always glad to tell a skunk where to go.
We're
Welcome to the Dwarf Waldorf, Susie Skunk.
Hello, Dippy Dwarf. Is Frankie Frog here?
No, he isn't, Sue. I believe he said he was going over to see Strauss the Mouse.
Strauss the Mouse?
Yes, for a music lesson.
Oh, dear. I guess I'll have to carry my radio over there.
It's not far to the Mouse's music studio, Sue. Just down the road by the brook.
Oh, thank you, Dippy, and goodbye. The music studio of Strauss the Mouse. Guess I'd better knock. Oh, I do hope Frankie Frog is here.
Greetings and subscriptions, Susie Skunk.
Hello, Strauss the Mouse.
Won't you step into my studio to music, perchance?
Thank you.
Likewise.
Strauss, has Frankie Frog been over here?
Nutch, but let's not discuss the frog. Useless here, my latest original composition, Skunk.
I really haven't time this
Sit time. Right down there. I'll see if my grandbaby's in tune. Perfect.
But Mouse, my radio needs repairing and
Please! I'm commencing to perform.
Oh, very well. What do you call your latest original composition, Strauss?
This one will make me famous. I call it Tales from the Blue Vienna Danube by Strauss the Mouse. Casting aspersions on my musical integrity?
I'm sure I don't know what you mean, but I don't see Frankie Frog here anywhere.
He ain't. You can look under the sheets of music if you don't believe it.
Oh, I believe he isn't here. Well, do you know where he might be?
Seems he said he was going by the Grasshopper's Junk Shop.
The Grasshopper's Junk Shop? Oh, do excuse me, Mouse. I have to see a grasshopper about a frog.
Juck, juck, juck. Everywhere look, say juck. A frog! Oh, for a minute there, I thought you were part of the juck, Frankie boy.
Hiya, General Grasshopper.
What can I do for you, by the way of juck?
Yeah, I'm trying to find a pair of secondhand snowshoes.
What does a frog want with snowshoes?
Well, they make dandy sweater stretchers. You ought to try them sometime.
Never wear sweaters, Basalt. Wool scratches.
Hey, what's that tobacco, Grasshopper? I'm wearing new spats.
Spotted spats are quite the thing over at Hazelnut Hollow.
Yeah, but I'm here in Wormwood.
Oh, Frankie Frog! Frankie!
Don't look now, boy, but a skunk's coming this way.
A skunk? Oh, hiya, Susie Skunk.
Hello, Frankie Frog, and a quick hello to you, Gerald.
It's nice of you to speak, child. Real democratic.
Please, I'm a pedestrian. Oh, Frankie, thank goodness I found you.
Now, what's so important, Susie?
My radio. It went floof! And I'm sure you can fix it.
Yeah, he can fix it, all right. Remember what he did to your food chopper, Sue?
Yeah, her food chopper? Oh, I did sort of get things mixed up, didn't
I? It's all right, Frankie. I needed a can opener all the time.
What seems to be the trouble with your radio?
I wouldn't be surprised if... Oh, do you feel the ground trembling?
Hey, golly, do you suppose it's
Don't get excited, folks. Only barbecue pig dropped down the road.
The pig? Oh, hello, Barbecue Pig.
Heavens, what's going on here? A political rally?
I should say not. This is an honest junk shop.
Yeah, we're trying to fix the skunk's radio.
It went kafloop.
And I'm going to fix it.
Nope, I'm going to fix it.
Yeah, probably a burnout tube.
A shortage of the wiring.
Yeah, I don't see any.
Hey, 'tis right puzzling.
Yeah, I thought surely I could fix it.
Stops me.
Can't either of you fix it?
Nope.
Here, let me see it.
Hey, Pig, you'll get your pig feet soiled.
I can afford to buy soap. I'm wealthy.
What does a pig know about fixing a radio?
Huh. Aha! The filter condenser's loose and the antenna cord's burned out. Oh, horrors! The oscillator's out of alignment. And there's a shortage in the transformer.
Condenser, antenna, oscillator. Is that all?
Good heavens, no. The transmission line is disconnected and the amplifier. Oh, that amplifier. Please, a screwdriver, someone.
What screwdriver? Coming up.
While you're getting it, bring over your toolbox. Susan.
Yes, ma'am.
Hold my purse. Franklin.
Yes, ma'am.
Take your hands off that purse.
Yes.
Clean that box off so I'll have an operating table.
Here the tools, Peg.
Good. Now I must have absolute quiet.
Screwdriver.
Screwdriver.
Pliers.
Pliers.
Tubes.
The tubes.
Speakers.
The speakers.
Condenser.
Condenser.
Frequency.
Frequency.
Modulator.
Modulator.
Now, will someone please plug in the radio?
A sure thing, Pig. You're there.
And I'll turn it off.
Hey, it works.
We now bring you Miss Fetlock's Billions, the story of a wealthy horse who wants to get into society, only to find that the social set gives her the horse laugh. In today's chapter, we find Miss Fetlock trying to crash the horsey set.
Oh, I knew that I'd crash the horsey set sooner. Oh, good morning, Colonel Sorrel. Don't tell me you walked all the way down to the track.
My dear Miss Fetlock, I always walk. I'm a Tennessee walking horse.
Oh, there's a dream horse. Stanley Stallion. Isn't he gated?
Well, my dear, we thoroughbreds never associate with him. Now, Miss Fetlock, there is the horse for a filly like you.
Oh, he is handsome. Such trim flanks. Such muscular withers.
Miss Fetlock, he's a Palomino from Texas, made a million in ore.
Oh, Colonel Sorrel, you must introduce me. He's so spirited. Look at the way he tosses his manly mane. Colonel, turn loose of my bridle. I just heard the call of the canyon.
Will Miss Fetlock gallop off with the spirited Palomino oil millionaire from Texas? Or will she be won by some trotter who is after her billions? Listen tomorrow to the next true-to-life chapter of Miss Fetlock's Billions.
I'll turn the radio off. There.
Oh, my radio is repaired, and I got to hear a soap opera. Can life offer more?
It sure can. Food.
Food?
Yeah, food.
It's time to eat.
And I left Kitty at home with the whipped cream. What a rude hostess I am. Pardon me, everyone, but I must run. Oh, Kitty, my radio is repaired.
Well, good.
I'm sorry I had to be away so long, leaving you here all alone.
Well, I haven't been alone, Susie.
You haven't?
No, go out and look in the kitchen.
Damn clock, my woodchucky.
Hello, sweetie Susie.
Chucky, you've been here all alone with Kitty.
Yes, but don't worry, sweetie. You'll always be the one I love. Every hour, every day, every year. I promise there will be no other skunk for me. You'll always be the one I love.
Oh, Chucky.
Susie, isn't it about time for another soap opera?
Maybe so, Kitty. You take the radio into the other room and listen. Now that my woodchuck is here, I found a program that suits me perfectly. Chucky?
Mighty me.
Although Susie's radio makes her happy, that can compare to the happiness brought by an honest-to-goodness woodchuck. Nothing, for Dumb Cluck is the skunk's favorite out of all the animals down in Wormwood Forest.
Hey, hey, that's all today. We're so glad that you could stay. There's always lots of fun down in Wormwood Forest.
And next time, we'll have exciting guests from Hollywood. Walt Disney, Mickey Mouse, and Donald Duck. Till then, this is Snippy Dwarf saying, so long.
Remember next Saturday, listen to our animal play. There's always lots of fun down in Wormwood Forest.
Wormwood Forest, written by Tom Tischner, has come to you from WSM in Nashville, Tennessee. This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.